السلام عليكم.
وعليكم السلام دكتور.
فاينل ان شاء الله وي ويل فينيش ذا لاست فور كارينيال نيرفز. كارينيال نيرف نمبر 9 10 اند 11 اند 12. Also each one have is a specific or a special story. We starting first by the glossopharyngeal nerve. Okay. Glossopharyngeal, what is the story of the glossopharyngeal? From its name, glosso. What means by glosso? Glosso? Yes, tongue. Okay. And pharyngeal means pharynx. Okay. If I will detect the branches of this nerve from its name, this is number one. Number two, this nerve 1973. So it is a parasympathetic also.
Yeah,
mixed nerve. Okay, good. Five. What is the nuclei? This nerve has motor, sensory, and the parasympathetic nucleus, like facial, motor, sensory, and parasympathetic. All 1973, motor, sensory, parasympathetic. The motor nucleus here. You will find in nerve number 9, 10, and 11, nucleus ambiguous. Ambiguous here mean hidden, not clear, ambiguous in the medulla. Sensory, like the facial nerve, nucleus solitarius. The parasympathetic nucleus in the facial nerve, it named superior salivary nucleus, but here it is named inferior salivary nucleus. Okay, again, the important nuclei, important. Ambiguous, we'll see this ambiguous in nerve number 9, 10, and 11. What means by ambiguous? Motor. What means by motor? Sublime muscles. Any muscle supplied by all these three cranial nerves, they were originating from nucleus ambiguous. Parasympathetic here means inferior salivary nucleus. Oh, we remember, you remember the GIT block, inferior salivary nucleus will give you tympanic branch, reach the tympanic cavity, the middle ear, forming the tympanic plexus, then give branch name the lesser superficial betrothal, relay in the otic ganglia, otic. But we have here many ganglia, otic ganglia related to the glossopharyngeal nerve to supply the parotid gland. This is the nerve supply of the parotid gland, parasympathetic. Okay, again. You have a parasympathetic here, inferior salivary nucleus, tympanic, then lesser betrothal. You have to differentiate between lesser betrothal and the greater betrothal. The greater betrothal from the facial nerve, supply the nasal gland, the lacrimal gland, and the palatine gland. But here it is named lesser betrothal nerve to the otic ganglia. You have the parasympathetic ganglia of the glossopharyngeal, it is named otic. And to supply the parotid gland. Okay, this is regarding to how the glossopharyngeal supply the parotid gland. But motor supply. Glossopharyngeal supply only one muscle only. So it is important, stylopharyngeus. Stylo, one of the muscle of the pharynx, named stylopharyngeus. Supply only one muscle. And the rest of that will be sensory. Sensory to what? Named glosso. So supply the posterior one-third of the tongue. If you remember GIT block, anterior two-third bilingual and the corda tympani, the posterior one-third taste and the general by glossopharyngeal nerve, tongue. And also pharyngeal, supply the pharynx sensory. Supply the tonsil of the pharynx, tonsillar branch. Tonsil, palatine tonsil. All this part, the nasopharynx, supply all the nasopharynx and tonsil. and also supply what is called carotid sinus. Carotid sinus. What means by carotid sinus? Here in the carotid, you will hear dilatation containing a carotid sinus. This carotid sinus is very important in chemoreceptor and baroreceptor control the blood pressure. This is a reflex. Inshallah, I will tell you what means by carotid sinus reflex. This is, in brief, the glossopharyngeal nerve. Again, mixed nerve, motor ambiguous, parasympathetic inferior salivary, and nucleus solitarius. Exit from the brain stem from the olivary fissure. Yes, we knew that before. Exit from the skull jugular. We have three nerves. Exit from the jugular foramen. So jugular foramen in the posterior cranial fossa. So any lesion, any tumor, any trauma in the posterior cranial fossa, jugular foramen will be affected. And which nerve, cranial nerve will be affected? Nerve number 9, 10, 11. Jugular. 9, 10, 11. Ambiguous, 9, 10, 11. Okay? Yes, will descend like that between internal jugular and the internal carotid. Then we'll go here. This is a glossopharyngeal nerve between internal and external carotid to reach the tongue. This is, in brief, the course of the to reach the pharynx. This is a glossopharyngeal nerve. Its origin like that. Supply the parotid gland. What is the branches? Number one, tympanic branch. I told you how it reaches the parotid gland by what is called the tympanic plexus, lesser petrosal nerve, otic ganglion, and the parotid gland. It is a parasympathetic. Motor, only one muscle, only supplied by the glossopharyngeal stylopharyngeus. And the carotid sinus here, it is named the carotid sinus reflex. Please don't forget, what means by carotid sinus reflex? Reflex. We love reflexes. Means it is formed of afferent and efferent. What means by afferent and efferent? Afferent here, number 9, glossopharyngeal, and efferent here by number 10, vagus. What means by carotid sinus? Any increase in the blood pressure, the information will be carried by glossopharyngeal up till the brainstem, then reflex will reback again or back down by the nerve number 10 vagus to decrease the blood pressure. This is named carotid sinus reflex. Carotid sinus reflex formed by 9 and 10. 9 afferent and 10 efferent. And also communicating with vagus, pharyngeal branch sensory to the pharynx, and the tonsillar to the tonsil. So this branch supply what? Supply one muscle, supply the all pharynx sensory tonsil, and so on, and glosso tongue. And the lingual branch, what to supply the posterior one third of the tongue. Yes, here, supply the posterior one third of the tongue. What happened if the glossopharyngeal injury? Huh? What happened to the patient here? Loss of sensation from the posterior one third of the tongue. This is the first step. What else? What else? Yes, glossopharyngeal, the posterior one third of the tongue. Yes, glossopharyngeal from the posterior one third of the tongue. Yes, glossopharyngeal supply only one muscle, stylopharyngeus from the post-olivary fissure. What else? The glossopharyngeal supply the mostly the palatine tonsil, posterior one third of the tongue, the pharynx sensory, and only one muscle, stylopharyngeus. And also give carotid sinus reflex to the carotid sinus, supply the parotid gland, the parasympathetic. Okay. If you wanted to test the glossopharyngeal lesion, you have to test the cranial nerve. Ask the patient, number one, by tongue depressor like that, tongue depressor. Put a tongue depressor and push the tongue down. The patient about to vomit. about to vomit. Any object inside the tongue, the depressor at the back of the pharynx, you will feel that you have to vomit or about to vomit. This is named gag reflex. What means by gag reflex? Also by number 9 and 10. What means by gag? Touching of the back of the tongue or the pharynx, it sends information afferent by 9 and descending by 10 to vomit. So in this patient, anyone have lesion of the glossopharyngeal nerve, you have a loss of gag reflex. If you put the sharp object, he no problem for him because loss of the gag reflex. What is the gag reflex? Touching the back of the henna, the glossopharyngeal nerve lesion, and number 1, dysphonia, يعني في ability في voice. Dysphagia. Dysphagia means difficulty in swallow due to the sensory of the pharynx. Absence of the gag reflex and the absence of the carotid sinus reflex. Loss of carotid and the loss of gag reflex. Gag reflex 9 and 10 and the carotid sinus reflex 9 and 10. Gag reflex touching of the back of the tongue, so about to vomit, but carotid sinus reflex low controlling of the blood pressure. This is the lesion Archie by the lesion of the glossopharyngeal nerve will be accompanied by facial nerve in the cerebellopontine angle.
And here it says carotid sinus reflex, meaning
yes,
loss. The what patient means, will not be, okay.
What means by carotid sinus reflex? Increasing the blood pressure, not controlled. So increasing and increasing. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this reflex to control the blood pressure internally without any drugs, without any interference from outside. So carotid sinus reflex mean increasing the blood pressure will be increased more and more, no reflex, okay? No controlling of the blood pressure. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Any question for glossopharyngeal nerve?
No, doctor.
Okay. Number 10, the same. What means by the same? Okay. Mixed nerve. 1, 9, 7, 3. So it is number 10, vagus nerve. Number 10, mixed nerve. Contain parasympathetic. What is the origin? The same of the glossopharyngeal. Motor, sensory, and parasympathetic. What is the name of the sensory nucleus?
Solitarius.
Solitarius. What is the name of the motor?
Ambiguous.
Ambiguous. Please, if I told you any muscle paralysis supplied by any of these cranial nerves, what is the nucleus will be affected? Ambiguous. Because ambiguous is a motor nucleus. Okay?
Yes, doctor.
Parasympathetic here, it is named dorsal motor nucleus of vagus. Please, you have to remember the name and the function of each nucleus. Dorsal motor nucleus of vagus, which lie in the dorsal surface of the medulla, the vagal trigone. Dorsal motor nucleus, it is a parasympathetic. Parasympathetic. The motor ambiguous, the sensory solitarius, the vagus nerve, from the post-olivary fissure, descending from the jugular foramen and descending in the neck vertically inside the carotid sheath to enter the thorax to supply the heart and the lung, then enter the abdomen to supply the GIT till the left colic flexure. So it is long nerve, the vagus nerve. Okay, branches, what is the branches of the vagus? Number one, vagus nerve give branch named auricular branch. What means by auricular? Supply the auricle and the external acoustic meatus. So I told you before, try to avoid any sharp object inside your ear. Why? It stimulates the vagus nerve. But what happened if the vagus is stimulated? The vagus is stimulated bradycardia until stop heart. تخيلهم. Cardiogenic shock until stopping the heart. vagus nerve, if stimulated like that, may be stimulated by shaving the beard by a sharp object, maybe during the take a shower in the very cold weather by a cold water, the vagus is stimulated like that. We heard about some person or players died inside the playground or inside suddenly, maybe stimulated vagus by any reason like that. But once the vagus is stimulated, bradycardia until stop heart. This is number one.
Same as vasovagal attack?
Yes, vasovagal attack. Most of us complaining from vasovagal attack due to any reason, any cause, maybe psychogenic causes, okay? Vasovagal attack, hypotension, falling on the ground, maybe bradycardia, maybe stop heart, Allah, yani, Allah yisallam, okay? This is the first branch, the auricular branch. The second branch, the vagus, it is the maestro or the master of the pharynx and the larynx and the palate. Please remember this good. The vagus nerve, the maestro or the master control of the pharynx, motor of the pharynx, motor of the palate, and also sensory and the motor of the larynx. How? Give branch name the pharyngeal branch. What means by pharyngeal to the pharynx? But this pharyngeal branch is sharing in the formation of what is called the pharyngeal plexus by motor. Motor branch. Yes, to the pharynx. Supply what of the pharynx? All muscle of the pharynx. Will supply all the muscle of the pharynx. We took it in GIT, like constrictors, muscle, superior constrictor, and the middle, and supply palatopharyngeus, except one muscle. Stylopharyngeus. Stylopharyngeus supplied by glossopharyngeal. Yes, this is number one. Number two, supply all muscle of palate. Soft palate. Palate. Except one muscle. You remember tensor? Tensor tympani and the tensor palati by mandibular of trigeminal. But all the maestro of the all muscle of the pharynx. So any lesion here, any lesion of the vagus nerve, the patient complaining of the muscle of the pharynx, he cannot swallow good. So difficulty in swallowing, بنقول عليها dysphagia. Dysphagia means difficulty in the swallowing. Dysphagia. Muscles of the palate, if the patient complaining of paralysis of the muscle of the palate, so regurg of the food from the nose. Regurg the food from nose. How? And during eating, the muscle of the palate close the opening between the nose and the pharynx. So it is not open, not closed good. So the food may be regurg from the nose. Okay. Number three, supply the larynx. Larynx. Supply, give two branches to the larynx. Number one, recurrent laryngeal nerve. Recurrent laryngeal nerve. Number two, superior laryngeal nerve. The superior laryngeal, it will divide again into internal laryngeal and external laryngeal. All are the branches from vagus. The vagus, the maestro of the larynx, sensory and the motor, external laryngeal again. But we have here recurrent laryngeal and the superior laryngeal. The superior will divide again into internal and external. Fine. Each one supply what? The external laryngeal supply only one muscle of the larynx. It is named the cricothyroid. Cricothyroid. The cricothyroid supplied by external laryngeal nerve. All the muscle of the larynx except the cricothyroid supplied by recurrent. All muscle of the larynx. All muscle of the larynx, vocalis, posterior cricoarytenoid, interarytenoid, all the muscle of the larynx are supplied by vagus except cricothyroid, Type. This is regarding the motor of the larynx. But the motor of the larynx, all muscles supplied by recurrent except one muscle, crico, by external laryngeal. But what about the sensory of the larynx? The internal laryngeal supply sensory above vocal cord. Recurrent laryngeal supply the sensory below vocal. This is regarding to the sensation of the wall of the larynx. Above vocal by internal laryngeal, below vocal by recurrent laryngeal. Please try to take the cranial nerves like a story. It is interesting. Vagus nerve auricular to the auricle, pharyngeal, all muscle of the pharynx except one muscle, all muscle of the palate except one muscle, regarding to the larynx, supply recurrent and the superior internal external, all muscle by recurrent except cricothyroid by external, internal laryngeal supply sensory above vocal, recurrent below vocal. Kida, you have supply the sensory and the motor of the pharynx, of the larynx, totally. Okay? What happened here if we have lesion of the larynx? Number one, hoarseness of voice. Of voice. What means by hoarseness of the voice? The voice of the patient like a horse. Hoarseness of voice. And also loss of sensation from the wall of the larynx. Anesthesia of the larynx. And also loss of gag reflex. And also loss of the carotid sinus reflex. I told you before, in glossopharyngeal nerve, we have two reflexes by 9 and 10. In the lesion of these two nerves, will loss of the of these two reflexes, carotid sinus reflex or gag reflex. You have vagus nerve, mixed nerve, motor ambiguous, dorsal motor nucleus of vagus, solitarius, from the busto olivary fissure, from the jugular the same, you have 9, 10 and 11 from the jugular, descend here in the neck between the vein and the artery until reaching the heart. This is a vagus nerve in between the artery and the vein and they give branches during its descent and they give recurrent laryngeal Hoshier care below the arch of aorta like that. What is branches? Meningeal to the dura of the posterior fossa, auricular branch supply the auricle, tympanic membrane, auricle, external auditory meatus, pharyngeal, all muscle of the pharynx except one muscle, all muscle of the palate except one muscle. The laryngeal branch is superior, internal, external. The external supply cricothyroid, the internal sensory above vocal. Recurrent, all muscles of the larynx except the cricothyroid, the sensory below vocal. And the cardiac branch to the heart. This is regarding to the branches of the vagus nerve. How you can test the vagus nerve is intact. Intact or no, ask the patient to speak to check the voice of hoarseness. Yani, if the patient is speaking good, there is a hoarseness or no, number one. Number two, test for swallow. Yani, he can swallow good or no, because to test the pharynx intact or no, difficult in swallowing or have any problem in the pharynx. Number three, ask the patient to receive, okay? Why to see the what is called the uvula? Please, this is very important. Here the uvula. You know uvula in Tom and Jerry?
Yes, doctor.
Uvula must be in the midline. The uvula is a part of the soft palate which is supplied by vagus. So any deviation of the uvula means lesion of vagus nerve of the opposite side. Again. Yani if the lesion of the uvula deviated to the left, so this patient have right vagus lesion. Uvula must be in the midline. Deviation to any side must hina means vagus nerve lesion of the opposite side. Oh. vagus nerve, maybe hoarseness of voice, dysphagia, regurgitation of the food from the nose, loss of the reflexes, blood pressures, abnormalities, and so on.
Doctor?
Yes, yes.
The uvula is supplied by the
vagus. Yes, it is a motor because the uvula it is produced by a muscle. So the muscle of the soft palate supplied by vagus. So the vagus nerve, the right and the left, remain the uvula in the midline. يعني the right, the one here pull the uvula like that, and the other one pull the uvula like that. So it is in the midline. So if paralysis is here like that in the right side of the vagus, what happened? The uvula will be deviating to the left side. Okay.
Yes, like yeah. The fist muscles.
By the muscle. Yes. Yeah. Okay. This is regarding to the uvula. Very important is the uvula in diagnosis of the vagus nerve lesion. It is very simple and very easy. And also by the voice of the patient and the swallow, you can detect also the vagus nerve lesion. Cranial nerve number 11. Number 11, alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, he is only motor nerve. Motor nerve. What means by motor? يعني no sensory, no parasympathetic, only motor supply, only muscles. What is the origin of this nerve? This nerve arises by two roots. He have a good story. He arises by cranial root, cranial part, the accessory nerve number 11, cranial part from the medulla, from the nucleus ambiguous. By nucleus ambiguous here, huh? Nucleus ambiguous is a motor, cranial nerve number 9. Yani the muscle of the vagus nerve, all the muscle supplied by vagus nerve. What is the origin of this muscle? Ambiguous or solitarius or the inferior salivary?
Sorry, again?
Again, the muscle supplied by vagus.
Mm-hmm.
Which is the nuclei controlling these muscles? It is
ambiguous.
Yes. ما شاء الله عزام عزام صحيح خلاص ها cranial also cranial part arises from the medulla from the nucleus ambiguous يبقى the accessory have two roots cranial from the medulla ambiguous and the spinal from the upper five segment of the spinal cord spinal يبقى this nerve have two roots spinal root and the cranial root spinal root from the spinal cord and the cranial root from the medulla from ambiguous. What happened? The spinal part or root will ascend and go inside the skull through the foramen magnum here and join with the cranial and form what is called united accessory, al-accessory al-mutahad, united accessory. What happened after that? This accessory will exit from the skull, from the jugular foramen. What happened after that? After jugular foramen descending inside the carotid sheath in the neck, this nerve will be separated again into cranial and the spinal. The cranial will unite with vagus and one of the content of the vagus fiber to supply the pharynx and the larynx with the vagus. But the spinal will go to the posterior triangle of the neck and supply two large muscles in the neck. All of us know that sternomastoid and trapezius supply two large muscles in the neck. Sternomastoid and trapezius. Again, very easy. Cranial and spinal. The spinal enter the skull and unite with the cranial to form the united accessory. This nerve will exit from the jugular. After its exit from the skull, will be separated again into the cranial and the spinal. The cranial will unite with the vagus and the supply with the vagus, pharynx, and larynx will be the fiber content of the vagus. But the spinal will supply two large muscle, trapezius, and the sternomastoid. Lesion of this nerve lesion of this nerve, the trapezius paralysis and the sternomuscular paralysis. What happened to the trapezius paralysis? The patient complaining from inability to shrug shoulder or drooping of the shoulder. Droop shoulder, drooping shoulder means depression of the shoulder, shoulder or inability to shrug shoulder. Type, what happened to the sternomastoid? Inability to turn the face to the opposite side. One of the action of the sternomastoid, turn the face to the opposite side. Yaba hena, the patient unable to turn the face to the opposite side.
Doctor? This is,
yes, yes.
I'm really sorry, but could you please repeat the course again?
Yeah, yeah. This nerve arises by two roots. One from the medulla. This is the medulla. This is a spinal cord. After its exit from the magnum, foramen magnum. One from the medulla, it is named the cranial. And one from the spinal cord segment, five or six segments forming together to form the spinal part. This spinal part of the nerve will go inside the skull again and unite with the cranial inside the skull. After that union, cranial and the spinal, it will form the accessory nerve. The accessory nerve will exit from the skull again from another foramen. This foramen named jugular. After its exit from the jugular, it will separate it again into cranial and the spinal. The spinal will supply sternomastoid and the trapezius, but the cranial unite with the vagus and supply pharynx and the larynx of the vagus. You got it?
Yes.
يعني هم two nerve, cranial and spinal unite together, and after its exit again, separated into cranial and the spinal again. The spinal supply only two muscles of the neck, sternomastoid trapezius, and the cranial will be one of the content of the fiber of the vagus nerve. Lesion of this nerve here, you can ask the patient to elevate the shoulder, he cannot elevate. Drooping of the shoulder means a lesion of the trapezius muscle, and also the patient unable to turn his face to the opposite side. This is regarding to the lesion okay. Any question, please?
No, doctor.
Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. Iba cranial part and the spinal part, then supply two muscles, jugular foramen separated again, supply only two muscles. Trapezius and the sternomastoid, inability to turn the head to the opposite side or face, and inability to shrug shoulder, yani elevate the shoulder, yani drooping of the shoulder, means drooping of the shoulder. Drooping. Of the shoulder. Alhamdulillah. We'll go to the last step here. This is the spinal accessory supply, the sternomastoid and the trapezius, like that. We'll go to, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, to the next step. Huh? To the next step, اللي هو hypoglossal nerve. Hypoglossal nerve. Very easy story. Hypoglossal nerve number 12. From its name, glossal means the tongue. يبقى the motor supply of the tongue. We took it before in GIT also. This is motor only, alhamdulillah, from the pre-olivary fissure and arises from the medulla, from hypoglossal nucleus, and the exit from the skull from the hypoglossal canal. Where the hypoglossal canal? Where? In the anterior fossa or the posterior fossa?
Excellent.
From the hypoglossal canal, and they will go like that, make a loop like that to reach the tongue. To supply the tongue, all muscles of the tongue except one muscle. I will tell you now. During its course, there is a nerve named cervical nerve number one. He asked the hypoglossal to run with him. Please, hypoglossal, I wanted to run with you. Okay, hypoglossal tell him, okay, no problem for that, you can. You will go with him. So it is named C1 along hypoglossal. Yeah, and the hypoglossal run with the fiber of the C1, run with the fiber of hypoglossal. Fine. What happened? We have another nerve named C2 and C3, cervical nerve number 2 and 3. They will be angry. Why? They will angry. Why? Because C1 run with the boss, with the hypoglossal nerve. So they will unite together to form, to be strong, and forming what is called descendens cervicalis. Descending cervicalis means descending and descending. Cervicalis and cervical nerve number 2 and 3. After that, the C1 here, oh my God, what happened? They will unite together and become strong. And they ask the hypoglossal to send a branch to unite with them to be more stronger. So C1 with hypoglossal send another branch to unite with the descendens cervicalis, this branch named descendens hypoglossi. These two descendens, cervicalis and the hypoglossi, named ansa cervicalis. Okay, good. You got it?
Yes, sir.
Yes, but C1 run with the hypoglossal. C2 and the 3 unite to form descendens cervicalis. C1 along the hypoglossal, this give a branch, its name descendens hypoglossal, will unite with the descendens cervicalis, unite together to form ansa cervicalis. Ansa cervicalis. Fine. What is the branches here? The hypoglossal here, it is a maestro of the muscle of the tongue. Hypoglossal itself, without any nerve, supply all muscle of the tongue. What means by all muscle of the tongue? Any muscle named the glossus. Styloglossus, hyoglossus, genioglossus, except one muscle of the tongue, not supplied by hypoglossal, supplied by vagus. This muscle named palato, because it is related to the palate. Palatoglossus. Palatoglossus. Remember it good, because it is related to the palate. So supply the palate, the maestro of the palate is vagus. C1 with hypoglossal. What is the branches of the C1 with hypoglossal? Descendens hypoglossi, and also to supply to muscle nerve to thyrohyoid, muscle named thyrohyoid, and muscle named geniohyoid. Geniohyoid. Thyrohyoid and geniohyoid. Iba join my first cervical nerve, internal jugular to reach the tongue. This nerve reaching the tongue like that, unite with the hypoglossal nucleus, except the contralateral side, like the facial nerve. The control of the hypoglossal nucleus mainly, which control the genioglossus muscle from the opposite side only. So lesion of the contralateral side of the tract will affect the contralateral genioglossus. What is the branches here? From hypoglossal itself, supply all the muscle of the tongue except one muscle, which is palatoglossus. Also the branch from the C1, descending cervicalis or hypoglossi, which unite with the descending cervicalis to form the ansa cervicalis, which supply the infrahyoid muscles, and also supply two muscles, geniohyoid and thyrohyoid. Thyrohyoid from thyroid cartilage to hyoid, and the genio from the genial tubercle to the hyoid bone. What is the lesion here? Lower motor neuron lesion, hemiparalysis of the tongue. And if you ask the patient to protrude the tongue outward, what happened? deviation of the tongue to the affected side, like that. Ask the patient to protrude the tongue. Why? To test where the hypoglossal is intact or no. What happened to this patient? Deviation of the tongue. What means by deviation? Yani, huh? The tongue is deviated to here, to the left or the right? Here.
Left.
So this patient have left hypoglossal nerve lesion. If the tongue is deviated to the left, means the left hypoglossal. If deviated to the right, so right hypoglossal nerve lesion. But the most characteristic lesion of the hypoglossal, deviation of the tongue to the affected site. Deviation of the tongue to the affected site. Like that must be during protrusion in the midline. So any deviation here mean hypoglossal nerve lesion. This is regarding to the what happened during the hypoglossal nerve lesion. This is the hypoglossal, this is the nervous accessorius or nerve accessory to supply the sternomastoid. The vagus will descend like that to reaching the thorax. The hypoglossal looping like that to reach the tongue. Glossopharyngeal to reach the pharynx. And this is the course of the cranial nerves.
Doctor,
yes.
I have a question.
Yeah.
I didn't understand why is it contralateral? The cortical nucleus, something in the slide that just written.
Again? This one?
In the slide that in before it says the hypoglossal nucleus receives cortical nuclear fibers.
Yes. Like facial. This is the hypoglossal nucleus here in the left side, and this is the hypoglossal on the right side. Yes? The hypoglossal nucleus receive from the one tract of one side and also from the opposite side, okay? But this is the part of the nucleus which is controlling the genioglossus muscle, receiving from the fiber from the opposite side only. Again, the hypoglossal nucleus receiving corticobulbar tract from the both sides, except the part control the genioglossus muscle. Receive it from the opposite side only, like fish. We have a phrase a note. بتقول إيه? All cranial nerve nuclei receiving bilateral corticobulbar tract in both sides, except lower part of the fissure nucleus and the part of the nucleus, hypoglossal nucleus, controlling genioglossus muscle. Okay? This is the slide.
What is controlling genioglossus?
What means by contralateral genioglossus?
What is, you said that hypoglossus is not motor to genioglossus.
Yes.
Then C1 along hypoglossus is motor to genioglossus.
No. I don't say that C1 with hypoglossal, geniohyoid.
Okay.
Not genioglossus. Okay. C1. With hypoglossal, geniohyoid, not genioglossus. In the muscle of the tongue by hypoglossal nerve itself. But here, you will see here, geniohyoid, from C1 along with hypoglossal. Okay?
Yeah, my question is, who is supplying genioglossus?
What is it? What is the nerve? The hypoglossal nerve itself. Hypoglossal nerve itself.
Okay.
Here. You will find it here. From hypoglossal nerve itself, all the muscle of the tongue. except the palatoglossus. What means by muscle of the tongue? Genioglossus. Okay. Styloglossus. And hyoglossus. This is the muscle of the tongue extrinsic. Except the palato. Palatoglossus supplied by vix. Okay. You got it?
Yes.
Anyone have questions here, girl? Any questions? I will remember if I miss anything during the final of the CNS. Hopefully, inshallah, it will be fine. Any questions here?
No.
Thank you, doctor.
كله تمام. Anyone have questions, please try to answer any questions in textbook, MCQ, online MCQ, and please tell me if you have any problem, okay?
Okay.
Inshallah, welcome and good luck, inshallah.
Thank you.
Assalamu alaikum.
Assalamu alaikum.